Good morning, children. So this class we are going to revise for the exam. Okay. So look at the pattern. So out of 50 marks you are going to write. So in that physics 15 marks, chemistry 15 marks, and for biology 20 marks. Okay. Chemistry. So totally 15 marks you are going to write in that short answers. Okay. For 10 marks for short answers and the remaining 5 marks for the detailed answer. Okay, short answers, totally 5 short answers you will be getting. Each question carries 2 marks. So, 10 marks and for detailed answer, 5 marks. Okay, so 15 marks you are going to write for chemistry. Right, children? So, some important topics you should learn, children. That's what I have mentioned here. So, what are they? Let me see now. First one, sample problems. Sample problems 1, 2, 3 is given in that introduction part, isn't it? So, that you should learn. Next one, definitions like isotopes, what is meant by isobars, isotones. For all these three you should learn with example. Okay, example also very important here. Next one, important formulas. Okay, followed by arrangement of electrons in the atom, what is meant by electronic configuration of an element. Next, progress of atomic models. Next, quantum numbers. What is meant by quantum number? What are the different types of quantum numbers? Next, important principles like Afba principle, Pauli's exclusion principle, Hund's rule. Okay. Next, electronic configuration of elements. And then definitions. Okay. Fundamental definitions like defined matter, defined atom, molecule, compound, like that. Okay. Ions. Next, limitation of Bohr's model. Okay, so totally 5-6 points are given in the book. No, so all the points you have to learn. If this question is asked in the detailed answer, then you have to write all the points. Suppose if it's asked in the short answer, means minimum 3 points are enough, right? Next, differences between a particle and a wave. Detailed answer. Next, experiments to prove particle and wave property of electron. In the two experiments are given in the book, one is the Davison and Germer's experiment and another one is the Thomson's experiment. Okay, so all these things you should learn. Apart from that, you have to draw the diagram of electronic arrangement of atoms in an element. Okay, at least totally 20 elements are given in the book. At least 10 elements you have to learn. Okay, so these important topics you should cover. Now take your book, take page number 3, sample problem 1. The number of protons on table column is given in that number of protons, neutrons as well as electrons in species A to E are given. Okay, so we have to indicate from the above table the species that represent a pair of isotopes. Okay, so table column is given in that species A to E is given, proton value is given, electron value is given, neutron value is given. We have to indicate the pair of isotopes. Okay, the species which contain the same number of protons but different number of neutrons are nothing but the what, isotopes. Okay, so species C and E contains the same number of protons. At the same time, if you check the electron, their values are differing. Okay, so species C and E are the pair of isotopes. Okay, in this manner you have to indicate. Next, 17 is the atomic number of chlorine. That also you should mention. Atomic number 17 is chlorine. So species C and E are two isotopes of chlorine. Okay, likewise you have to prepare. Next come to sample problem 2. Composition of the nuclei of two atomic species A and B is given. For A and B, proton value as well as neutron values are given. You have to identify the mass number of A and B. For that, what you have to do? You have to know the formula, then only you can find out the mass number of A and B. What's the formula? Mass number is equal to number of protons plus number of neutrons. Proton value is given, neutron value is given. If you add these two, then you can get the mass number. In that manner, you have to find out. Okay. Next, come to the sample problem 3. Which two of the following nuclei are isotopes of each other? Okay, so isotopes means what? Atoms with the same atomic number but different mass number. Okay, elements with the same atomic number but different mass number is given. Based on this, you have to find out the isotopes, right? Next, isobars. Isobars, these are the atoms of different element with the same mass number but different atomic number. Okay, same mass number but different atomic number is nothing but isobars. Okay, here two examples are given, argon as well as calcium example is given. If you find these two elements, their atomic number is differing but mass number is same. Based on this, you have to identify the isobars. Okay, next come to isotopes. Isotopes, these are the atoms of different element with the same number of neutrons. Here, what carbon as well as nitrogen is given as an example. You have to write the what atomic number as well as mass number. If you subtract these two, then you will get the same number of neutrons, right? Next, present concept of atom, that is important formula. Okay, what's the first one? Coulombic force, F is equal to K Q1 Q2 by R square. Next, centrifugal force, F is equal to mv square by R. Okay, and you have to mention what is K, what is Q, what is R, what is M, everything you have to mention it. Okay, next, angular momentum, L is equal to mvr. So these three formulas you should learn, children. Next, come to the arrangement of, in page number 5, arrangement of electrons in the atom. In the diagram is given, go through the diagram. Okay, so next, turn to page number 6. Here, what is known as the electronic configuration of an element? The arrangement of electrons in the various shells of an atom of the element is known as the electronic configuration of an element. So, two more questions, right? Next, come to page number 7. Limitation of Bohr's model. So, totally 5 points are given. If this question asks me the detailed answer, you should write all the 5 points. Okay. So, next one, turn to page number 8. Page number 8, difference between a particle and a wave. That's also a detailed answer only. The left side particle is given, 3 points are given with the examples. And right side for wave also 3 points are given. All the things you should learn with the example, right? Next, come to the experiments to prove particle and wave property of electrons. In this, verification of wave character, okay, that is Davison and Germer's experiment as well as Thomson's experiments are given. Both the experiments you have to go through, okay, read the experiments well and find out the concept of that experiment. You have to mention the at the end of this and at the end of that answer, you should mention the concept of the experiment. What's the concept given in that? Both the experiments, okay. Suppose if this experiment only asks, means no need to mention the Thomson's experiment, okay. So read the question twice and then write. Next, come to page number 11, quantum numbers, okay. Quantum numbers means what set of 4 integers are defined to define an electron completely in an atom is called the quantum numbers, okay. Then what are the different types of quantum numbers? Principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number, magnetic quantum number, spin quantum number. Okay, each and every quantum number, it describes, some quantum number describes the shape of the electron, some quantum number describes the size, some quantum number describes the orientation, and what spin quantum number describes the angular momentum of the electron. And for each and every quantum number, it has some integral values. That values also you should mention. Got it? Right. Next, come to the same page, rules for filling of orbitals. In that half-bar rule, half-bar principle, Pauli's exclusion principle and Hund's rule. Okay, these rules are very important. You should learn all the 3 rules, right? Next, come to the page number 30, electronic configuration of elements. Okay, so here in page number 14, nearly 20 elements are given. So you have to learn all the elements. First you should learn the atomic number of the element, then only you can draw the electronic arrangement of atoms in an element. Okay, so for example, see the first element, hydrogen is given, its symbol is H, isn't it? At the same time, if you take the atomic number of hydrogen is 1. Okay, so you have to mention just one electron only. Based on this, we have to arrange the what electrons, okay? So next, helium, lithium, beryllium, okay? For all these elements, you have to learn the symbol and also its atomic number. Then only we can draw the electronic configuration or electrons arrangement of an atom in an element, okay? So these are the important topics you have to cover for the exam children. Don't omit anything, everything you should learn. Then only you can write the exam well. Okay children, prepare well for the exam. All the best.